Welcome to Donington Park. Hope you enjoy the video. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, and go follow my Instagram and YouTube page.
Take a look around me.
Is it good?
Yeah.
What happened at South when we ended up full of gravel? Is that where you went off?
Someone spun,
like right,
and then backed up, so I couldn't get across that bridge, so I couldn't get across the gravel. You
So you see a yellow flag safety car, no fuel.
Yeah, well,
qualified P20, which no one really wants to qualify there. You always want to try to qualify up front. Just I need to sort out a few more bits, little tiny bits, which can be, if you add them all up, can be a lot. I'm just going to try on qualifying. I need to focus on the gap of the toe, how far I am and how close I am. Also depicting if there's two of them in a team, how much gap they're going to lose when they roll out and all of that type of stuff, so I can get them the perfect toe. Two safety cars out, which limited the amount of racing time we had. But besides that, the start was very good, except for I tried a move, like going around the outside of everyone on the first lap whilst they were defending. It didn't work out too well and we dropped down 8 positions again. But as the race continued throughout, we managed to gain back up into 18th. Yeah, the next race is at it's 5:10, and we're starting 19th there. But we're hoping for that race, we're going to end up finishing a lot further up the grid, ready for the last race on Sunday. That Sunday race, where I finish in this next race, will be where I start for that. And we're hoping I can sort of get up into top 10. Then I've got actually a fighting chance of the rookie trophy, if possible, and getting a podium finish. The track's, it's very fast for how big it is. There isn't really too many slow corners. Like the first corner, it's more complex and more deceiving as it is, because it is one of those where you have to always keep a high minimum speed up, so you can get all the way up, because you've got a massive downhill straight. Well, not really straight, it's a little bit wiggly, but in there you're pulling sixth and getting ready for the old hairpin, which is a very fast right-hand corner. Which quite a few people spin on there, as what happened in the race. We had a little collision there. To take into next season, I want to take all the experience I've learned from this year and like all the track experiences, so when I show up to some tracks I won't be brand new to them, so I'll be able to crack on straight away. And I've also got a little bit more experience myself, so I know now how the Ginetta races are going to be. Well, they're going to be a little bit unpredicted next year because we're going to have a lot more drivers in. Let's hope it'll be another good year. I want to finish top 3 in the championship. That's what I want to do for next year's goals. That's what I was hoping for this year, maybe getting a rookie podium. But there's a lot of brilliant rookies here and we just haven't had a good enough year really to fight up top. Thank you for everyone following me. Thanks to my dad, Josh, my race team and Declan for supporting me through this part. And also thank you to my sponsors for helping us out and following me through.
How does your week look building into the race weekend?
Yeah, pretty busy actually. I have all the corners off the car, make sure everything's all in good condition, keeping everything nice and tidy, all clean. And obviously each team will have their own little tricks on what they do with the cars, but yeah, you just keep on top of it all, make sure the car's good to go, organising the lorry, spares, just keeping everything tidy.
Is there anyone to your inside here?
No.
Okay.
So, get...
on his door.
Yeah.
Don't go out here, you're lost. Get on his door, look at everyone. Tim,
yeah.
Commit in a bit more speed, okay?
So should, should I maybe try it in this
one? You're more to the inside on this one. Have you looked at where you're on the grid?
Oh, yeah, no, I'm on that side, yes.
Yeah, you're more to the inside in this one. Trying to get into that gap there. He's always going to come out, but then look how tight he's took it. You could have been there now.
Yeah.
Come back. On his door. Literally, move over. On his door. Now you're parallel with him. Now you stay with him. Stay on his door, and then come literally in on his bumper. I'm not saying smash into him, but I'm saying in there, you're on his bumper, you're going with him, you're leaving too much of a gap all the time.
He knows what to expect, he knows all the little ins and outs, the procedures of drive, even like down to simple things of leaving the awning and driving to park Fermi. He knows all them procedures now, and all them things are quite a lot for a 14-year-old to deal with. It's not just get in the car and drive, it's right drive through the paddock when there's 20,000 people walking around, and dealing with all that pressure and dealing with other people. So he comes into it a little bit more understanding to it. Obviously has a bit more of a grasp on things. So moving into next year, fitness, biggest thing, get fitter. 100% get fitter. He's got, coming with that fitness will come with a little bit of a weight loss. He's not a big kid, he's not a fat kid at all, but coming into motorsport, it's all about being as lean as you can, as strong as you can. And that entail helps your fitness, which then helps your mental side of things and helps you deal with pressure situations. You're not blowing, you're not tired. Process becomes a lot easier, basically. Go look at it. If you were to look at McNeely this year, and McNeely was his first year last year, in a very similar position to us, was with a decent team, didn't have a teammate as far as I'm aware, so didn't have the advantages of getting towed around the circuit, learning off of someone else's data, all them things. He finished okay last year, didn't know exactly where he finished, but then this year he's fighting for the championship. There's no reason why Zach can't do that next year. There's no reason why Zach can't be pushing to the front. It's all down to him just putting in the time, putting in the effort, fitness, out of hours, debriefing properly, learning all the other things, the data, all that stuff really sinking into it. There's no reason why he can't win it next year.
That's what you gotta remember, is you've gotta make them moves, you've gotta get your elbows out, just like you did towards the end.
Yeah.
You got a bit of confidence back then. At the end there, you P11, you could see the top boys with him. The guy who won it was within view.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the first time you've had that this year. So take that drive, as in drive you, not drive the car. The drive that you had in that car, take that forward.
Yeah.
Take that for the next one, okay?
Yeah, definitely happy with the result I just had in the second race. Managed to go up 8 positions from 19th to 11th. And it's just really ecstatic I am right now. Well, in the race, at the beginning, we had a good start compared to the last one. We didn't lose any places. We actually gained a few more places. And we tagged onto some of the fast boys, and then we went through the pack a little bit quicker through everyone. And then, unfortunately, there was an accident which happened in the last corner, which involved in a red flag and a race restart. In the race restart, I accidentally overheated the clutch, so when I went to start it, it wouldn't go straight away. There was a long delay in the clutch. That made me lose a few places, but then as the race progressed, we managed to get through back all those places and ended up finishing up higher as well. And some of them were really eerie moments, like when I went on the grass to pass some people, and besides that, it was just mega. Compared to all the results I've had in the last races, which were meh, they were not good, and now to this one where I've finished up high with a good bunch of lads, and how I've just gone from pretty much the back of the pack to now the front of the pack, and I've now stamped my mark that I'm there, and I'm getting ready for the next race tomorrow, and let's hope we can get further in that.
To the old town road, I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I got the horses in the back, horse jack is attached. Hat is mad as black, got the boots as black to match. Riding on a horse, you can whip your Porsche. I've been in the valley, you ain't been up out that porch. How can nobody tell me nothing? You can't tell me nothing. Can't nobody tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. Riding on a tractor, lean all in my bladder. Cheated on my baby, you can go and ask her. My life is a movie, boy riding in boobies. Cowboy hat from Gucci, Wrangler on my booty. Can't nobody tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing.